Ryan Smith here, joined by Madison Capitals head coach Luke Strand. Coach, obviously we look back at the week prior, and it's obviously one that you and your team want to set aside after dropping an 8-1 decision on Friday to Chicago, then 4-2 on Saturday against Bloomington. Obviously, bitter tastes in everybody's mouths, but how do you look to build off that and get them back on into a positive train of thought moving forward?
I think it's just time to refocus and take some things and grow out of some situations there. Obviously, we had an opportunity to come back in a lot of games there for a stretch, and we didn't get that done. And we just got to work on playing from the front and at the same time finding a consistent measure inside of our lineup. And we're missing some players, but that should equal opportunity, not just an excuse.
Yeah, we talk about those newcomers, Kenny Hausinger being one of them, who got to see his first couple games as a Capital this weekend without an Egla, a Richter, or a LeClaire. How has the transition been getting him and some of the other new guys into the lineup? And do you think there's just a little bit of a wearing in period where guys just sort of have to get used to the new personnel around them?
Yeah, I think there's part of that. I think the other opportunity there for them is to really step up. And at the same time, there's people inside of our room that have had, those guys play some pretty big minutes for us that aren't here. And we're really looking for some guys to grab onto those situations and take advantage of that. And right now, instead of looking left or right, they should look in the mirror a bit and take advantage of that, because it is here.
Now we look ahead this week. Schedule did not leave you guys any favors right before the break. You had a home-and-home with the USHL's best team, the Cedar Rapids RoughRiders, Thursday at the Stable and then Friday night here at the Coliseum. How do you examine this matchup, since it's been a while and you have a lot different team than the first time you saw them?
Yeah, I think that first it was our opening home game here, and I do think their squad's talented. They're missing some players themselves, and they've got Franck, who's the leading scorer in the league as far as scoring goals, and they've had solid goaltending all year long. And Mark's a terrific coach there with his 500th win underneath his belt. So it's one of those scenarios right now where we need to forget about what's going on and now just really focus on the moment. And CR is our next project, and they're a talented track meet team. You let them go, they're going to run. And we got to take care of the puck and really give a 60-minute team effort here.
After CR, nice little break for the Christmas holiday for your squad before a couple more home games and then a giant road patch to begin January. Talk about how important it's going to be for everyone to get re-energized after the break and get ready and raring to go on the road for some pretty long ones at that.
Yeah, it's terrific. I mean, guys get a home chance to support their family. They've supported them so much throughout their lives and really get around friends, family, time away from me probably at the same time. So that's all a blessing. At the same, I hope they'll be excited to come back. Usually the case, I mean, you get a good shot in the arm and then you have that opportunity to come back. And then we jump right into it with a couple home games. Then we hit the road. We said Lincoln and Muskegon and Youngstown. Those are trips to be talked about. But right now, it's going to be, you got to be about CR, and you got to be about taking care of ourselves here and leaving those opportunities for their families to come when they get here.